the video on Twitter when I smashed my club and then the horn went off. I had to come back out the next morning to finish. And that was where I, this was that shot.
So. Okay. That was the, where you, after your drop? Yeah.
So it was funny. I remember talking to Johnny. I was like, I honestly think I'm going to drop this ball in the first cut on the downslope instead of the tee. So if you look, it's like, you can see that I didn't drop the ball on the tee. I dropped it in the first cut on the downslope. Why?
Yeah.
It's because I was hitting a 3-wood off the ground. Okay. It's kind of tight, narrow up there. And the first cut was just the right height that it wasn't ever going to sit down. And it was, so it was just a little bit higher. So it was going to sit up and I could get, it was almost like a tee. And then the downslope just kept the ball low and it kept it running, which I needed. So it's like, I think I'm going to drop on the downslope right here. And he's like, I love it. And so there was obviously a lot of water right there because it was dew. It was first thing in the morning, first shot. And then that shot started out the rest of the day because I hit it right in the fairway, hit my wedge shot up there and made the putt, made five,
yeah.
Which I would have paid an ungodly amount of money to make five after that drive.
Yeah.
Like insane. So then that led me to make the cut, which led me to finish, I think, like 30 something, which got me in the Masters.
Got you in the Masters.
So that shot was the shot after the shot.
Right.
If that makes sense.
Well, because people, you know, that kind of, that clip sort of went a little viral there of the block smash horn splash.
Right.
But the, you know, the second half of that story is coming out the next day.
This is it.
There it is.
The shot after the shot.
Getting it done and going to the Masters.